How do you bring about change? How do you inspire others when you hate yourself on the inside? How do you lead people when you don't have the confidence and strength to do so? How do you move onwards knowing that your actions have consequences? How do you control those losses? How do you prevent others that have nothing to do with it from getting hurt? How does one act as a leader? For years when I was younger, I wanted nothing more than to be alone, to build a fortress around my heart and not let anyone in. But the older I get, the more often I am thrown into uncomfortable and unfamiliar situations. Times where people look up to me for answers. Moments when I am expected to take charge. I don't have an answer. I never have. But perhaps we can find one through the actions of protagonist Lelouch from Code Geass. Set in a fictional world where the Holy Empire of Britannia rules a third of the world, the tyrannical emperor has established a military state that prides itself on the superior blood of its people. Within the nations that it conquers, the native people are valued as less than human and labeled as numbers. Social Darwinism becomes the guiding principle of the empire, where the strong are valued and the weak are deemed worthless. Of these captured nations is Japan, referred to as Area 11 by the empire. Lelouch, a Britannian student who is secretly the estranged son of the emperor, finds himself caught in the crossfire between Japanese rebels and the Britannian army. Gifted with a special power to make people act according to his will, he embarks on a quest to secure a better world for his crippled and disabled sister, Nunnally. To change the world and overthrow the Britannian Empire, he becomes the leader of the Black Knights under the guise of Zero. It is through his actions as a leader that we can learn part of what it takes to become one. There are common traits and skills that we associate with leadership. Things like strength, confidence, perception, and good social judgment. There is the theory that leaders are born from the traits they inherit. There's also the theory that leaders can be born through the skills they acquire. But Lelouch isn't physically gifted, and socially he isn't the best either. Being a good leader doesn't mean that you have to be all those things, you just have to play towards what you're good at. What Lelouch does embody is an extreme amount of intelligence and strategy that is vital towards his progress. The opening of the show begins with him winning a chess game that becomes a motif throughout the rest of the series. Through each battle and conflict that arises, he treats them with the same amount of precision and wit that he would in chess, carefully moving each piece and anticipating his opponent's next move. He doesn't lead through strength, but through results. He gains the trust of others because he wins when no one else can. You and I are far from perfect beings. We are fallible, meager humans just taking it day by day, doing whatever we can to survive. But think of leadership as a play, a movie, and you as the main actor. None of us are truly as confident and strong as we wish to be, but we can try to act like it. Stand up straight, walk with some guidance. It is through these small efforts that we lay the foundation for a better future. But to say that leadership is a bright and cheerful position would be a lie. To say that everything I had said thus far is easy to do would be false. Leadership is a road wrought with destruction, pain, and deceit. With every action, there is a consequence. People will get affected. People will get hurt because of the calls that you have made. Heavy is the head that wears the crown. It may sound like a cliche, but the idiom speaks volumes to those that dare to listen. Lelouch is not a good person. He lies, he manipulates, and his special ability makes doing so that much easier. But to be an effective leader, perhaps you cannot be a good person at every moment. The many articles and textbooks that you will read on leadership will advertise only positive advice. They'll tell you that you need to be friendly, that you need to be aware of other people's feelings, that you must adopt those skills and traits that I mentioned before. While all this and more is technically true, I want to present to you an alternate theory on leadership, one not born out of the benign platitudes we are raised upon, but rather on the darker aspects the world would rather not show.
You'd know that I believe that psychopaths are not a mistake of nature. They're a gift.
A gift?
They're alpha wolves who help the human race survive long enough to become civilized. An indispensable demographic.
You believe that?
Did you know that that psychopathic traits can be found in the most successful CEOs, in the most effective politicians? Without psychopaths, mankind wouldn't exist today.
Well, there's a lot of mankind that doesn't exist because of them.
Every silver lining.
We can define psychopaths as those with antisocial personality disorders. People who have long patterns of manipulating, exploiting, and violating the rights of others without any remorse. Lelouch is not a psychopath. Rather, he shows great affection for his sister Nunali and his best friend Suzaku. He even felt deep remorse for what happened to Shirley, Rolo, and Yuffie. Yet, he takes on the traits of a psychopath in order to win, in order to become an effective leader. He uses his power to manipulate people to do his bidding. He lies and hides secrets from his team. He puts his entire army at risk to save his sister, not just once, but twice. For the occasional moments when he does show sympathy for others, there are a dozen more times when he puts his own selfish goals over the needs of the many. Leadership under the mask of Zero becomes an act, a performance for Lelouch that, at times, becomes impossible for him to bear. But again and again, he pushes onwards with the act. Every battle, every conflict becomes a performance. With thousands of eyes and hearts looking up to him, he performs his lines and finishes each scene with absolute finesse. For much of the series, war becomes a game of chess to him. His army were pieces and pawns that he moved and directed to put himself one step closer towards victory. And victory to him wasn't necessarily about the freedom for the Japanese, or even ending the tyrannical reign of a brutal empire. It was only about his sister. Is he wrong to do so, however? Is it really that wrong to manipulate others if the ends justify the means? In the end, he is successful. He sacrifices himself to create a better world free of inequality and discrimination for his sister Nunali to live in. People are happy, and though some have paid the price with their lives, no death was in vain. Why do we as a society champion the light but neglect the power of darkness? Right and wrong is a matter of perspective. Light and darkness are but tools in a much larger game. You can embody or acquire the traditional traits and skills of leaders, or you can take a different approach. You can lie, you can manipulate. It is up to you to decide what tools are best for the job. What I want to propose is that there really is no right or wrong way of leading. You will never be all that you imagine yourself to be. Being the perfect textbook leader is impossible, a far-off fantasy. We live in reality, a twilight world that stands at the edge of our dreams and desires, but what comes raining down from those dreams are moments and opportunities to prove yourself. Lelouch was a normal person until he was gifted the chance to become something more, but despite his abilities and intelligence, he was far from perfect, and so are we. In that moment, when all heads and eyes are pointed our direction, we can only give what we have. It is through those honest and human actions people may come to respect you. While lies and manipulation seem far off from the right thing to do, it's simply what happens in the heat of the moment. So when that day arrives, What tools, what skills, what traits will you use? What are you willing to sacrifice to reach your selfish goals? Are people chess pieces in a much larger game? Do you lead by force like Lelouch, or do you lead by ushering in change from within the system like Suzaku? The ultimate test of leadership isn't just in the results that you deliver. It's the test to see if the people who once followed you will be there once they see you for who you truly are. Will they stand alongside you when they learn your secrets? When they find out you're not as strong as you appear to be, will they still believe in the legend? Will they carry out your will? Will they shout your name? Leadership is a position, a temporary role, a crown passed onto one person from the next to carry on the weight of the world. It is a mask that we put on for the scene of our careers, so make of it what you will. The power of the king will condemn you to a life of solitude. Are you prepared for this?
Cause we're gonna shout it loud, even if our words seem meaningless, like I'm carrying the weight of the world. I wish that some way, somehow, that I could save every one of us, but the truth is that come to life.